The focus today is going to be to talk about total knee replacement. I'd like to discuss briefly how I used to do it and how I'm currently doing knee replacement, and then I'd like to discuss why we made that change. First, what we do. This is your tibia and this is your femur. This is your leg bone, okay? And in the middle is your knee. To do a knee replacement, we have to remove some bone from the top of your tibia or shin bone and the end of your thigh bone or your femur. I think it's important to understand the differences between manual total knee replacement and robotic total knee. When cases are done manually, a device like this goes on the leg, and then a saw blade, freehand, just in my hand, rests on a device like this, and we use regional anatomy, we try and line this up and use this as a plumb line to make a cut that's perpendicular to the shin bone. That's the way the vast majority of knees in the United States are done right now. In order to improve accuracy and reproducibility, we started introducing robotic-assisted surgery. And so instead of using plain x-rays, a two-dimensional image, we're now using a CT scan, a three-dimensional image. We can plan substantially more accurately because of that. Better planning coupled with better execution. This is a patient's knee, and in all the different planes, I know exactly what size is going to fit that patient perfectly, how much deformity they have, whether or not I'm going to line up the femoral component or thigh piece right, the tibia piece right, and it's going to be rotated properly and sloped properly. Each of those things have an important impact on outcome. We then have a patient laying on an operating room table just like this. We have to put pins into the bone because I have to educate the computer about where that patient is in space. The computer knows exactly what they look like. I have to teach them where they are in space. In order to do that, you need a reference frame. That's these pins in the tibia and these pins in the femur. So patients will have two small poke holes above their knee incision and below their knee incision. The reason for that is so that these arrays can be present such that we can register the patient and tell this computer where that person is in space. So instead of using our eyeballs, our hands, our experience, and tools like this, we're now using a sophisticated robotic-assisted device to be able to shape the bone. So now, when I want to cut exactly 8 millimeters of bone from the end of the femur, this will literally lock into the right position and will only allow me to remove the bone I planned on removing, as you can see on our three-dimensional plan preoperatively. All the different cuts are now driven by CT-guided, robotic-assisted bone preparation instead of using eyes, hands, experience, and two-dimensional images.